Dear students, once again I resumed you with the further topic of French Revolution. Students, firstly be ready with your note, pen, pencil and notebook. As what I just teach you, you can just note down on your study material for further study. Dear students, in last video, as I explained you about the growing middle class of France. And at the end, I was just discussing that the educated class of peoples who are just created, right, are just influenced with the ideas of the philosophers, the ideas of the scholars just residing in different countries of Europe. So, dear students, today I will tell you few philosophers and their ideas that help to influence the peoples of the third estate of France, right, for participating for revolutions and for contributing for political changing. As I explained you in earlier video that the peoples were few peoples of the third estate were just engaged in overseas trading, and due to they were just moving around the different countries of Europe during that time. Whenever they just moved to different European country, they just met with the different peoples and they influenced with their ideas. So those peoples also inspired the popular philosopher, right? So in this topic, in summarized way, I have explained few scholars or philosophers, right? These are very important for examination point of view also. So many objective or short questions answers just asking on these philosophers. Apart from this, I just want to say that there are so many questions just come out in examination that what were the different roles of the philosopher for outbreaking of the revolution in France. So it is very necessary to study these all topics. Clear? So dear students, these philosophers, right, just expanded the ideas, right? They gave the various ideas regarding equality and freedom. So all those philosophers who expanded the ideas of equality and freedom will be liked and favored by different peoples of France of the third estate, right? Firstly, it is necessary to understand all of you that what is the meaning of philosopher or who were the philosopher. The philosopher, the simple meanings, having extended ideas, having expanded ideas on any issue. You can define the philosophers are those persons having broad ideas over issues of the society and over different matters of the society. So during that time, the different philosophers had idea about to there should be a society, there should be a political system. Those are just based on equality and freedom. So those few philosophers who just favoring these ideas are first John Locke, second Jean-Jacques Rousseau, and third Montesquieu. These three philosophers are just discussed in your book, right? So firstly, John Locke just write down a book, Two Treatises of Government. That is very popular book, right? Two Treatises of Government. About this book, there were so many times different question is asked in your examination, and apart from the examination in BPSC and UPSC, the question is asked. So the John Locke wrote a book, two treaties of government, and in this milestone book he wrote down that the refute the doctrine of the divine and absolute right. In this book he wrote that whatever the absolute right is given the rulers, right, and ruler are independent, rulers have their own ideas, whatever the rules are made by them, and that has to follow to everyone. So it was just refuted by John Locke just tells that whatever the different absolute rights will be given the rulers, it should not be given. There should be some limitations of the right, and the rulers will take decision with group of people. So whatever the absolute right was given to rulers, it was forbidden by John Locke, and it is just explained in two treaties of government book. Second, it was view of John Locke, whenever a lot of or absolute right will be given to the rulers, they can be dictatorship or they can be corrupted. So it is necessary that the right must be limited to rulers. Second important philosopher was Jean-Jacques Rousseau. Jean-Jacques Rousseau, commonly popular as Rousseau, he wrote very important book and very popular book named The Social Contract. In Social Contract, he had explained about the voting rights. And in this book, he has explained that every persons or every citizens of the country must have voting rights, and on the basis of voting rights, whatever the peoples be elected must be rule over the country, and there should be the formation of the democratic government. The meaning to say in one line that Rousseau just advocated the idea of the democratic government based on equal voting right. I think it is clear to everyone. Our students, the third important philosopher during that time that influenced French society was Montesquieu. Montesquieu has written a book, The Spirit of Laws. In his book, he has explained about the power, right? He explained in his book that the power should be decentralized. Power should not be centralized in one hand. Whatever the system earlier just going on in Europe as well as in France, the power was just centralized in the hand of the rulers. So he advocated that power should be decentralized, and whatever the power is decentralized, obviously there were so many peoples are responsible for playing their powers, right? And the government, based on the decentralization of power, he explained about divisions of power on the basis of legislative, executive and judiciary. In one line, whatever the right now system just going in whole world, right, where there is democratic government, is just based on this idea of the spirits of the law written by Montesquieu. The government's power should be decentralized. Dear students, the ideas and statements of these scholars influenced a lot the European society, and these all ideas enlightened the society of Europe also, right? The same thing, what its result just happened, that due to these enlightened ideas, these ideas are just discussed in different society of Europe, not only in European society but in French society. Now common peoples are just aware what type of government should be happened, what type of role of government should be happened. right? When these ideas just became popular and just going to be debated and discussed in the society and different common places, different marketplaces by the common peoples, these ideas spread among the common peoples of whole society. And when this idea to be expanded to educated to uneducated, upper class to lower class, rich class to poor class, working class to workless class, obviously this will cause for the demand of the changing. So one side where all those peoples are wanting for changing political system, wanting or demanding for few rights, the another side with empty treasury, Louis XVI was planned for imposing new taxes. Resultly, what will happen, you know very well, and I will further be study in next video. So the story is going to be very interesting, my dear students. So wait for the coming video with burning issue. Thank you. Have a nice day.